Well, welcome to another edition of Political Woodstock. This is a special edition. It's a cure to injustice. It's called the truth. It's called hard work, faith, and some lucky breaks. I'm going to talk about a case that happened in Tulsa, along with the Innocence Project. Innocent Project is a group of people. It varies through state that work on projects that are believed to be that the people accused of crimes they did not commit, that they are innocent and they are serving time for a crime they did not commit. Enter Malcolm Scott, DeMarque Carpenter. They were being held in Tulsa jail's general population. They were awaiting a ruling all the way back in February. It's May now. I'm going to hold off telling you what happened. And we're going to go back in time. We're going to go back to May of last year. Yes, we're going to go back. All right, what was Angela doing? Okay, she's working with We the People Oklahoma. She's gathering signatures. That's right. Signatures for the petition. Remember the grand jury investigation into the Tulsa County Sheriff Department and then the Tulsa County Sheriff Stanley Glanz? You guys thought I was just talking. But this wonderful group, headed by Mark, M-A-R-Q, Lewis, amazing man, wonderful organizer. People have a lot to learn from him. This group, a group of citizens, went before a court to petition the court for this grand jury investigation. Well, some interesting things happened along the way. I was doing some podcasting on Blog Talk Radio, and because I was ill one night, and they were downtown in Tulsa protesting the death of Eric Karas. He was killed April 2nd, 2015, and Robert Bates, a volunteer deputy with the Tulsa County Sheriff, who has since been found guilty, I am happy to say. We were doing protests, lots of different things like that, but I could not be there. So I fired up my Blog Talk Radio podcast. And it's this podcast that we're going to listen to. Let's go to it. Oh, I see somebody in the chat room. Really? Okay. All right, let's start this. I'm going to do some background music. Let's bring it down a little bit. And I think if I scroll it up to 8 minutes, it might be starting there.
Archer Pine. I think it's Garrison. Maybe wrong about that one.
I don't hear it, do you?
But in that area,
it's about a triangle-shaped area.
Do you hear it?
American residents of Tulsa had to live, work, and have their businesses in.
Oh, my headset's not working right.
They were very...
I'm going to have to really turn it up.
And at one point, some of the white citizens began to get jealous of that area. They couldn't go to the white establishments to shop. They could only go to your area.
All right, what I'm doing right here, I'm discussing 1921 and the Tulsa race riot, which was the largest race riot in the history of our country, of the United States of America, that is. I forget we have international listeners on Spreaker.
And at that time, there was a lot of lynch mobs.
Okay, let me see if I can move it up a little bit.
And she talks about this. Machine guns put upon the building.
There was a school teacher that wrote a journal about her experiences during the 1921 race riot in Tulsa.
as they walked and tried to
massacre is more what it was.
History books will show a small number of people being killed in this race.
About this time is when the aunt calls in.
Arkansas River is a beauty.
This is weird to listen to myself.
River on the outskirts of Tulsa.
Oh, this is awful. I gotta mute myself.
I don't see a beautiful river. I see a cemetery. For during this time, as I heard from a survivor that witnessed this, her name was Nancy Busey. She was 90 at the time when she told me this, and this was in the 1990s. She said they had trucks, you know, the type of trucks that had the wood. They were work trucks, the wood pieces up the side to carry more materials. And the materials that they were carrying were African-American bodies that had been shot, hung, burnt in this race riot. And they dumped the bodies into the Arkansas River. Tulsa has another side. A side where African-American men and women are shot down in the streets. Not a lot.
This was in 1921, by the way.
Someone needs to tell the sheriff that it's time to change, and it's time for him to resign. And that's part of what this petition is about. Well, that is what the petition is about. It's to get a grand jury.
We're back in time, May 2015.
Tulsa, Oklahoma. This is a good way of effecting social change in an environment where injustice has been the norm. Let me get this real quick. So, and it's not just African Americans that are a minority here. Native Americans are the second largest minority in Oklahoma, and this is true in Tulsa. Latino Americans are the number one minority in the state of Oklahoma, and true for Tulsa. African Americans are the third largest minority. They all share in this injustice. They are all victims of this injustice, of this elitist mentality that somehow their lives are not as important as others.
Soon the phone call happens.
Me.
I think I'm trying to get to my studio at this point.
Oh, there it is. I like that one. There is an artist by the name of Killer Mike. He has a song named Reagan.
Oh, that's a good song.
God is in the building. Beach Lord. And
awesome. Awesome artist.
Take a look at the studio and see if I have callers. I see one caller that's called in. If
all right.
You want to speak, you'll need to press 1. Let me go ahead and open up the chat room. I just realized I had not opened up the chat room. I apologize for that. And let me get that going. This is the premiere show of We the People of Oklahoma. They have a website. I'm sorry I don't have it. They just started it about 2 days ago. So, got that. All right, I see your hand up. I have the chat room open. And let me go ahead and bring on this person. Area code 817. If you can hear me, you are live.
Hello?
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. What about you?
I'm doing well. I'm doing very well. I'm not able to be to the event, so I thought I would do this. My friends that are doing this event are now currently marching. I'm waiting for some of them to call in. Are you calling from the event or calling as a listener?
No, I'm calling from another state. I'm from Oklahoma, Tulsa, Oklahoma. And I was calling about how they my nephew Corey Atchison went to trial Judge Harper, and they railroaded him, and he's been in prison since 1990 and for something he didn't do, and they know he didn't do it, but they say he was not going to get out.
Was he arrested by the Tulsa Police Department or Sheriff?
The police. It was the sheriff or the police. I don't know which one he was arrested by. But I know he had a court, and everybody thought he was going to be innocent, and even the boy got up there and testified and said he didn't do it. They made him say he did it, and they still just locked my nephew up, and he's been in prison ever since 1991. And he's in Granite, Oklahoma now, and he's been locked up ever since, and they know he didn't do it.
And you say this was a murder?
Yes. He was trying to give them mouth to mouth and help him, and they arrested him, and they railroaded. They know he didn't do it, but they told my son, we know he didn't do it, but he never get out.
Well, I cannot make any promises, but I can tell you that we are gathering 5,000 signatures for this petition. We've been granted the right to get this petition and to get the signatures to get a grand jury investigation into the sheriff, Glanz. And I'm hoping that this will work, and this is going to expose much more than what we want to expose. You know, all the dirty stuff behind the curtain. And he's been sheriff since 89.
Well, and district attorney, who's the district attorney now?
Goodness, it's on the tip of my tongue, but back in 89, I believe it was Don Moss, correct?
I'm talking about 90.
I think it was Don Moss then. They named a jail after him. But he died in the 90s.
I have two more nephews that have been in prison since 95 for something they didn't do.
Since 95. What are their names, son?
Malcolm Scott and Marco Carpenter.
Marco Carpenter?
Yes.
Is that correct? Was this a Tulsa charge?
Yes.
Tulsa.
Yes.
Tulsa cases. If you want to talk about it, you're welcome to. If you don't want to talk about it, that's all right, too.
Yes, they locked my nephew up, Corey Atchison, as I'm talking about first. They locked him up for killing this guy. I can't remember his name because I don't have all my papers right in front of me. But I have all from the Tulsa Eagle, Oklahoma Eagle, and you know where the boy got on the stand and told that he didn't do it, and then they told this white guy, they kept him in lockup and tortured him and told him to say he did it or else they gonna put it on him. It's been a whole lot went on, and in 95. My nephew was at my house. I got on the witness stand and told them, and they still gave him three life sentences.
Got on the stand. Is that Malcolm?
Malcolm Scott. He was at my house.
I have no idea what this grand jury is going to turn up, but I hope a lot of people will get freed through this. It's my sincere hope.
And they tried to say Malcolm killed the guy in Quick Trip, and the man who they got, and he was doing, they done killed him now on death row, and he made a petition and told people Malcolm didn't do it. He lied. Or Marco, he signed a petition saying they didn't do it, but they still haven't let him out.
My God. It's hard to know what to say. I mean, I know these things go on. I know they do. I've heard in the Native American community, I've seen and heard horrible things similar to this. But it's always shocking to hear it. No wonder you left Oklahoma. No wonder.
Oklahoma.